Star Wars Squadrons is an exclusive dogfight experience in the Star Wars universe. The game is trying and succeeding to satisfy your X-Wing vs. TIE nostalgia while implementing new features and multiplayer modes to the franchise. Squadrons is divided in two different modes, a single-player campaign and a fully developed multiplayer mode that attempts to compete with other space titles like Elite Dangerous. But how well made is the game, and can its single player campaign or multiplayer mode help it to stand above the competition? Let's find out. Hello everybody, I am SquidofLove and this is a first look at Star Wars Squadrons. Squadrons is a beautiful game with great graphics that you can also enjoy in VR. The campaign cinematics will make you feel like watching a Star Wars movie, and that can only be good. Gameplay, however, is limited only in dogfights. There is nothing else you can do, just pilot your fighter, follow commands and fight the enemy. During the campaign, you get to play as two pilots, a rebel and an imperial one, while following their intertwined stories. While the story sounds like your typical Star Wars plot, the design is nice and promising. As I have already mentioned, you are only piloting in this game, which is nice if you are after the action, but can become old fast, especially if you were expecting a little more depth. There are scenes inside your allied capital ships where you get to talk with your companions or listen to your next mission briefing, but you are not allowed to move around. You are glued to the spot and can start dialogues or leave the room by choosing a person or a door with your mouse. This, to be totally honest, has left a very sour taste to my mouth and killed my enthusiasm for the game. It makes the whole experience feel very shallow. I would have preferred the full-on cinematics, briefing type of cutscenes than this pseudo freedom to interact with other characters. Gameplay in space and dogfights are good, but nothing extraordinary. If you are new to the genre or a big Star Wars fan, you will be pleasantly surprised. If you have experience from other titles, again, the game will feel very shallow. The flight model is decent and gets the job done, but is nothing special and at times feels very arcade-like. You can find everything you were expecting here: different weapons to use, power adjustment, boost engines, weapons or shields to get an advantage over your enemies, and have decent AI to fight. Strategically placed cinematics make the experience better, but in general, combat turns into a chore after a while for experienced players. Two very annoying things I have to mention are first the claustrophobic cockpit of the TIE, with struts blocking the view, and the need to smash keys to get your fighter back in action when it has been disabled by the enemy. Multiplayer offers a few options as well, but nothing extraordinary. The main mode is normal deathmatch, where you get to fight your enemy in a 5v5 fight till you reach 30 kills to win. Players can choose from up to 4 different ships with different purpose and equipment. You can also unlock new weapons, modules and cosmetics. Fleet Battles is the mode that makes multiplayer better. A 5v5 battle with goals this time. In this mode, you have to destroy enemy capital ships while dealing with enemy players and AI and defending your own capital ships. It is a nice system that you have to be level 5 to unlock, and honestly kind of saves the entire game. But even that can keep you entertained for so long. If you are only interested in the multiplayer part of Squadrons, Fleet Battles is a nice mode, but I really doubt of its longevity, if there aren't more additions and features in the near future at least. Overall, I think that although Star Wars Squadrons is a nice addition to the space genre that allows us to experience a movie-like Star Wars adventure and some good Fleet Battles, what it really offers is not good enough for its price tag, especially if you are an experienced player. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like, subscribe and turn on bell notifications. I am SquidofLove and I will see you next time. Bye bye.